power to issue writs or writ jurisdiction of Supreme Court and High Court of India under Article 32 and 226 is a very important question for civil service examinations and for all the law examinations. So what is the power of issuance of writs? Under Article 32, Supreme Court can issue 5 types of writs: habeas corpus, mandamus, prohibition, certiorari and quo warranto. And under Article 226, High Court can issue similar writs. Again, by Article 32 itself, Parliament by law can confer this power of issuing writs on any other court within the territory of India. Some important points. Who can issue writs? Supreme Court and High Court can issue writs. Number 2, against whom these writs can be issued? Basically, these writs can be issued by Supreme Court or High Court against the lower judiciary or against administrative tribunals. Depending upon the case, these writs can be issued against detaining authority or public authorities. Before the year 1950, power of issuance of writ was only there with the High Court of Calcutta, Mumbai and Madras. After 1950, this power is conferred on all the high courts within the territory of India and on the Indian Supreme Court. What is the difference between Article 32 and 226 regarding writ jurisdiction? Under Article 32, any person can go to Supreme Court for violation of fundamental rights. Under Article 226, High Court can issue writs for the violation of fundamental right or for the violation of any other right. It can be a constitutional right as well. Next question. Origin of the writ jurisdiction. These writs are borrowed from British law. In Britain, they were called as prerogative writs. Prerogative means a special privilege because these writs were issued by King and Queen only. Now this power is conferred on Supreme Court of India and Indian High Courts, and they are called as writs, and issuance of writs or that jurisdiction is called as writ jurisdiction. That's it for the day. Again, I'm making a very short video on each and every writ, and again the detailed videos as well. So stay tuned till my next lecture. Goodbye and good luck.